Google and Meta know us better than we do ourselves. Amazon is an indispensable trading partner for countless retailers, and Twitter has the power to block a US president's free speech. Over the past two decades, big tech companies have grown from tiny startups to become the gatekeepers of the internet. Legislatures, regulators, and competition authorities worldwide, including especially in the European Union, are struggling to find the best way to deal with these digital gatekeepers. But while big tech is new, economic gatekeeper power is not.
My name is Justin Lindeboom. I am an assistant professor of European law at the Faculty of Law of the University of Groningen, and I do research on the theory and history of gatekeeper regulation. From the late 19th century until the 1970s, AT&T and its Bell system maintained a monopoly in the entire US telecommunications industry, controlling everything from telephone equipment to long-distance calls and local exchange. AT&T was, in fact, the gatekeeper to the use of the phone, until it was broken up by the US competition authorities in 1982. What can such historical examples of gatekeeper power teach us about the regulation of big tech today? What lessons can we learn from the way in which authorities tried to regulate gatekeeping in the past? What values and goals have guided gatekeeper regulations, and to what extent were these regulations successful? These are some of the questions I address in my legal theoretical and legal historical research into gatekeeper regulation. Today, much of the academic debate about big tech regulation focuses on the question of whether big tech companies are efficient and whether curtailing their power will increase or decrease consumer welfare. Amazon, for instance, benefits consumers through low prices and tremendous product choice. But the fact that Amazon owns an essential platform for thousands of online sellers, while at the same time competing with those sellers with its own brands, creates an obvious conflict of interest, which might be a problem as such. The history of economic regulation shows us that efficiency and consumer welfare are not the only values that matter. Sometimes companies become so powerful that their power itself becomes a problem, simply because they are capable of threatening the public interest and possibly even our democratic institutions. Balancing efficiency and power requires value judgments. It is up to us to decide how we want to strike that balance and if and how we want to regulate big tech companies. But the history of regulating gatekeeper power can teach us valuable lessons for making those decisions. My goal is to improve our knowledge and understanding of this history to allow us to make better legislative and regulatory decisions today.